Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss the following question. And the question says that, solve the following linear programming problem. Maximize z equal to 120x1 plus 100x2 subject to 5x1 plus 3x2 is less than equal to 15, 2x1 plus 2x2 is less than equal to 8, where x1 is greater than equal to 0 and x2 is greater than equal to 0. We are given a maximization problem. Maximize z equal to 120x1 plus 100x2 subject to 5x1 plus 3x2 is less than equal to 15, 2x1 plus 2x2 is less than equal to 8, where x1 is greater than equal to 0 and x2 is greater than equal to 0. Here, all constraints are in the less than equal to form. And the constants on the right hand side of the constraints are non-negative. So this is a standard maximization problem. And we will solve it algebraically using simplex method. So here, our first step is to write the given linear programming problem with constraints having equal to symbol. For this, we will make use of slack variables. We will add S1 and S2 variables. Such that S1 is greater than equal to 0 and S2 is greater than equal to 0 to the given constraints so that we can write them in the equal to form. So, we get the following constraints. 5x1 plus 3x2 plus S1 is equal to 15. 2x1 plus 2x2 plus S2 is equal to 8. Here x1 is greater than equal to 0. x2 is greater than equal to 0. S1 is greater than equal to 0. And S2 is greater than equal to 0. Also, we can write the objective function z equal to 120x1 plus 100x2 as minus 120x1 minus 100x2 plus z is equal to 0. So we have the following equations. 5x1 plus 3x2 plus S1 is equal to 15. 2x1 plus 2x2 plus S2 is equal to 8 and minus 120x1 minus 100x2 plus Z is equal to 0. Note that we have written the objective function in last. Now we write the initial simplex table. In these three equations, we have x1, x2, s1, s2 and z variables and their respective coefficients on the left hand side, and on the right hand side we have constants 15, 8 and 0. So we write these terms in the form of a table. First we fill the columns of x1, x2, s1, s2 and z. In these columns we have written all the coefficients of the variables from the equations. These columns form a coefficient matrix of the given equations. In the last column, we have written the values written on the right hand side of the equation. Now see, the columns of S1, S2 and Z form the identity matrix. So the variables corresponding to these columns are called the basic variables and we write them in the first column. Note that always write Z and its coefficients in the last row. Now our next step will be to determine the entering basic variable. To select entering basic variable, we look at all the numbers in the bottom row, that is where we have written Z in the last row, excluding the last entry on the right, that is in the right hand side column named as RHS column. So here we have minus 120, minus 100, 0, 0, 1 in the last row. Minus 120 is the most negative, so x1 is the entering variable. Now our next step will be to select the pivot element and the outgoing basic variable. Here, x1 is the pivot column. Now we find the positive ratio. For this, we divide each entry on the RHS column by corresponding entries of the pivot column, leaving the last row entry. We have ratio 15 upon 5 equal to 3. And 8 upon 2 equal to 4. Now, 3 is minimum of the two ratios and it is corresponding to 5. So we choose 5 as the pivot element in the pivot column. Also, the corresponding basic variable to this pivot element is S1. So, S1 is the outgoing basic variable. We mark an arrow here. This row is the pivot row. Now next, we make the pivot element equal to 1 and all other entries in the pivot column 0. Now, x1 is the new basic variable. We have to make the pivot element equal to 1 and all other elements in the pivot column equal to 0. So we will have to first divide the pivot row by the pivot element. So we get this table in which the first row is divided by the pivot element 5. Now we make 2 and minus 120 in the pivot column 0. For this we use specific row operations. R2 goes to R2 minus 2R1 and R3 goes to R3 plus 120R1. So we have the following table of values. As R2 goes to R2 minus 2R1, we have the values 2 minus 2 equal to 0, 2 minus 2 into 3 by 5 is equal to 4 by 5, 0 minus 2 into 1 by 5 is equal to minus 2 by 5, 1 minus 0 is equal to 1, 0 minus 0 is equal to 0, and 8 minus 2 into 3 is equal to 2. Similarly, in the last row, as R3 goes to R3 plus 120R1, we have minus 120 plus 120 is equal to 0, minus 100 plus 120 into 3 by 5 is equal to minus 28, 0 plus 120 into 1 by 5 is equal to 24. 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. And 0 plus 120 into 3 is equal to 360. This is the second iteration. Here we have negative entry in the last row, that is minus 28. So we continue with the next step. Now we shall repeat steps 3 to 5 until there are no more negative numbers in the bottom row, with the possible exception of the RHS column. Here we have minus 28 as the negative number in the bottom row. So we choose x2 as the entering variable. And it is the pivot column. Now we choose the pivot element using the same method used in step 4. We find positive ratio by dividing element of the right hand side column, that is the RHS column, by the corresponding element in the pivot column. We get 3 upon 3 by 5 is equal to 5, and 2 upon 4 by 5 is equal to 5 by 2, which is equal to 2.5. So 2.5 is the minimum of both values. So S2 is the outgoing basic variable and 4 by 5 is the pivot element. So we write X2 as the entering basic variable in place of S2 in column 1. Now we have to make 4 by 5 as entry 1, 3 by 5 as entry 0, and minus 28 as entry 0 in the pivot column. So first we make pivot element 1 by using the row operation. R2 goes to 5/4 R2, we get 0, 1, -1/2, 5/4, 0, 5/2 in this row. Now on row 1 and row 3, we use operations. R1 goes to R1 -3/5 R2, and R3 goes to R3 +28 R2. We get the following table. Now, all the values in the bottom row corresponding to Z are positive, so we are done. The RHS column gives the solution to the linear programming problem. Corresponding to X1, we have value 3/2, and corresponding to X2, we have value 5/2. So the solution of the given linear programming problem is X1 is equal to 3/2 and X2 is equal to 5/2, and maximum value of Z is equal to 430. This is our required answer. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.